The individual is currently experiencing a mix of emotions, feeling perplexed and torn. They have a strong connection with you, but are not fully prepared to act on their emotions. Uncertainty and unresolved issues between you two are holding them back. They are unable to move forward and are reluctant to let go of the past. It's evident that they hold you in high regard, think about you often, and desire closeness. However, they might also have an unrealistic perspective of the situation. Past negative experiences in relationships may be affecting their ability to form healthy attachments with others, and there might be emotional baggage between you that is inhibiting their progress. Their current emotional state is leading them to believe that maintaining distance is the right course of action. They are grappling with sadness and have much healing and self-discovery ahead of them. They may not feel that you or anyone else genuinely cares about them or that they are capable of pursuing something new at this time. This situation may change eventually, but it could take several months. During this period, they need to focus on their own well-being and healing. For now, their intention is to maintain their distance, as they require time to heal and sort things out. They might consider reconnecting in the future, but their first priority is self-care. In this challenging time, it's important to be patient and understanding, letting them know you're there for them if they need support, but not pressuring them to move at a pace faster than they are comfortable with. My reason for ghosting you has remained unspoken until now, but I can no longer keep it to myself. I disappeared because I felt that you were too good of a person for me. I feared that your positive influence would change me, compromising my innate sense of freedom. Commitment also frightened me, as I wasn't ready to shoulder the responsibilities it entails. In hindsight, I acknowledge that my actions were foolish and that I made a mistake. I genuinely believe that I deserve another chance to demonstrate my love for you. My fear was that your love would alter me into someone unrecognizable. I've always valued my independence and didn't want to lose it. I believe that letting you in would require me to conform to your expectations, potentially at the expense of my own identity. I also worried that allowing you to love me would necessitate a transformation into a better person, which I wasn't prepared for at that time. The idea of commitment was intimidating because I wasn't accustomed to being responsible for someone else's happiness. I thought it would mean sacrificing my freedom and doing things I didn't want to do. I was also averse to the hard work and effort required to sustain a successful relationship. I now realize that my excuses were weak, and I hold myself responsible for my selfish and immature behavior. I've learned from my mistakes and come to understand that you are the best thing that has ever happened to me. You are the most kind, loving, and supportive person I know, and I aspire to be the person you deserve. I'm pleading for one more chance, promising that I will be different this time. I'm more willing to compromise and work diligently to make our relationship thrive. The third-party situation in this connection revolves around a karmic partner. This implies that the person you are interested in has a connection from a past life with someone else, and they are still dealing with some unresolved issues from that previous lifetime. For most of you, your person has likely already left their karmic partner. The karmic partner may have made efforts to reconcile with your person, but this time your person didn't entertain those attempts. However, your person hasn't completely closed this chapter with their karmic partner just yet. They are close to doing so, but there seems to be a minor delay preventing the closure. Karmic relationships can be highly intense and passionate, but they can also be challenging and filled with conflict, drama, and power struggles. These relationships are often meant to teach us important lessons about ourselves and our relationships. In this situation, it appears that your person has separated from their karmic partner, but they are still emotionally attached to them in some way. This attachment might be conscious or unconscious, but it's hindering them from fully opening up to you. Various factors can make it difficult for someone to close the chapter with a karmic partner. This may include lingering feelings for the karmic partner, a fear of loneliness or being hurt again, or a reluctance to confront the pain and trauma from the karmic relationship. If you're hearing this, it's likely that your person's karmic partner has recently re-entered their life, indicating that there's a lesson to be learned or unresolved business to address. It's crucial to understand that your person's feelings for you are not diminished by this. This situation signifies that there's something your person needs to learn or heal from. During this time, your best course of action is to be patient and supportive, letting your person know you're there for them and love them unconditionally. Avoid pressuring them to make a decision about their relationship with their karmic partner. It's also important to protect your own energy and set boundaries with both your person and their karmic partner, avoiding getting drawn into any drama. The distance your person is creating between you and them is because they need to fully close their karmic cycle before they can commit to you. This doesn't mean they are rekindling their relationship with the karmic partner, they're just tying up loose ends. It demonstrates your person's seriousness about you and your connection. They won't lead you on, they're taking the time they need to be fully present in your relationship. The best way to support your person during this period is to be patient and understanding, encouraging open communication and helping them identify and learn from the lessons of their karmic relationship. Your person will reach out to you soon as they are on the verge of closing this cycle. This message underscores your deep connection and commitment to healing and growth. Your confidence throughout this challenging time is a testament to your strength and resilience. You believe in your person's love for you and trust that they will make the right decision for both of you. Your person is nearing the closure of their karmic partner cycle, indicating they are ready to move on and fully commit to you. While this may not happen immediately, it is in progress. In the meantime, focus on your own healing and personal growth as you prepare for the wonderful relationship that lies ahead with your person.